that Mystic Odysseys of Theros has dropped, we now have the official stats for the Leonin and the Satyr. Right now, we're taking a look at the Leonin. And first thoughts, these guys just don't quite have as much to keep them up to par with like what the Tabaxi got, and especially not compared to what the Satyr got. The Leonin, I really did have a lot of hopes for. I guess, to me, I thought that they could have done a lot more mechanically with this race. I think it could have been cool for them to get a pounce that potentially knocks something prone. It's something more unique, martially, than just a natural weapon attack. But let's go ahead and get into it. The Leonin guard the Shining Lands of Orescos. Sorry for like mispronouncing anything, I'm not really big on the Magic the Gathering lore and all that. A golden plain where even the gods rarely trespass. Prides of these nomadic lion-like humanoids rarely interact with other peoples, having all they need in their shimmering homeland and knowing the treachery of strangers. Still, some Leonin wonder what lies beyond Orescos's border mountains and seek to test themselves in a wider world. So here with the Leonin traits, ability score increase, your constitution score increases by 2, and your strength score increases by 1. Your strength is for, you know, niche builds. You're talking barbarian, fighter, paladin. I use pugilist at my tables, and ranger with strength base, and some clerics that use strength. So, strength scores are, well, strength saves are one of the weak saves in the game. So I just think getting an increase of strength is just kind of like, okay, it's going to really help out some builds, but overall, it's just not as great as something like Dexterity or Wisdom or Constitution. Size, your size is medium. Speed, your base walking speed is 35 feet. So them and Satyr both get this 35 speed. Dark vision, you can see in dim light within 60 feet of you. So they're getting the standard dark vision here. Claws, your claws are natural weapons, which you can use to make unarmed strikes. If you hit with them, you can deal slashing damage equal to 1d4 plus your strength modifier instead of the bludgeoning damage. Normal for an unarmed strike. Honestly, I don't see a ton of people building this into Monk whenever Tabaxi's available. So, like, if you would have made this a 1d6, I think it would feel totally fine. And honestly, I think that they need that. They really deserve to get a 1d6 out of this. Hunter's Instincts. You have proficiency in one of the following skills of your choice: athletics, intimidation, perception, or survival. I don't know why they only get one skill of their choice from this list, and then Satyr got two proficiencies that, yeah, sure, they were predetermined, and then a tool proficiency. It's way better than what they're getting here. Daunting Roar. As a bonus action, you can let out an especially menacing roar. Creatures of your choice within 10 feet of you that can hear you must succeed on a wisdom saving throw or become frightened of you until the end of your next turn. The DC of the save equals 8 plus your proficiency bonus plus your constitution modifier. Once you use this trait, you can't use it again until you finish a short or long rest. Frightened, especially with like classes that give you perks to that, like Conquest Paladin, this is going to be really killer for that. So much so that I've decided to add Oath of Conquest Paladin into my subclass rankings on my race and class synergy analysis table. And then languages, you get to speak, read, and write, common, and Leonin. So let's just go ahead and go over to the table. If I did this correctly, then I believe that the Leonin is only going to get a 22 on the Detect Balance rating. I think maybe the Frightened thing could push them up possibly closer to a 25. But they're just... Yeah, it seems like they're missing out on something that could really boost them up. You know, like, everyone's going to draw the comparison to Tabaxi. Tabaxi's sitting at their 25. But if we look at, like, even the Satyr as, you know, it appears in the same book, the Mystic Odysseys is thick. The Mythic Odysseys of Theros, Satyr's getting a 43. So, I don't know. I don't know why the Leonin just feels like it got really neglected here. I have given it all my rating so far, factoring in some of the new subclasses and stuff I'm adding in here, as well as I'm starting to put Ross Leiser's stuff on here and some of Magehand Press's. So, bear with me as I add more and more to this. It's becoming a pretty crazy document. For all the accursed, accursed choose either intelligence, wisdom, or charisma for their curse, affliction, like ability score. So since Leonin's not getting a plus to any of the mental stats, it's only got a C. Alchemist, also a C. Alchemist from Mage Hand Press is all about intelligence and dexterity for their improvised weapon attacks. So Leon is just not getting a big boost to anything there. Artificer, B, simply for the +2 to the Constitution, and that being the strong save of the Artificer. Absolutely for Barbarian, S+. They're also getting a feature on top of Rage that they can use once a short or long rest that allows them to inflict the Frightened condition. They're getting all the love from the +2 to con, +1 to strength. It's fantastic. Bard C, not getting any help with dexterity or charisma. Bloodhunter Dex B, mostly for the +2 to their constitution and then some of the other effects they can get. Bloodhunter Strength is absolutely S+. And in fact, whenever I made this, I thought about that and I was like, man, that's a really cool character concept. I'm not gonna lie. Cleric, the only one that's really helpful here is the Cleric for Strength, which is an A+, would be S if they had any help in their Wisdom. Druid, C. Fighter, Dex, C. Fighter Strength, S+. Anything that you're getting your Constitution and your Strength increase is, yeah, that's going to be killer. I think with Champion, if you went the route that I really want to go with it, where I would give them a Pounce attack and knock it prone, then this could be a really killer pairing, because then you've got advantage on the roll and you're more likely to fish for crits. So, yeah, I'm giving that an S+ for now. Cavalier, S+, same thing. Eldritch Knight, A. Because Eldritch Knight now, I'm going to weigh intelligence a little bit heavier on this. Otherwise, it would just be like, you can roll Eldritch Knight and not really prioritize your spellcasting ability modifier. And, you know, you're still going to do damage. But for Eldritch Knight, if they don't get some help with intelligence, from here on out, I'm kind of docking that some ratings. Magus, across the board, B. Again, same reasons for the Accurse. They're just not getting any help with a spellcasting ability modifier. However, for the B, you are getting stuff to help out the martial aspect of it. And the Magus can be played as a frontliner, so I'm going to sit it there. My Merchant, now you can see I've added my classes in on here. For my Merchant, it's going to be a C because the Merchant's going to prioritize Charisma. So, yeah, and their strong save is going to be Wisdom, I believe. I should know better. Monk, C, no help with Dex or Wisdom. I'm really trying to think of anything else that could help bring something like that up, but they're going to be way better if you just throw this on Pugilist. For the Mystic, the reason I've given it a B, at least for my Mystic, is that my Mystic has a lot of play into concentration checks, so that's why I feel like the boost of the Constitution is enough to at least put this at a B. Paladin S, however, the Paladin Oath of Conquest is absolutely S+, and I think that might be the best subclass for this race, like, in the game. The Frightened condition, being able to do that on a short rest, it's a way for you to mimic the effects of your Channel Divinity, which is tied to a long rest, I believe... Future Terran, correct me. For the Oath of Conquest Paladin, the synergy of you inflict the Frightened condition, and then whenever something's frightened, whenever it's so close to you, it takes additional damage. Like, that is so killer. That is, I would honestly say, probably the premier pairing for this race. Absolutely. Pugilist S+, and actually I really love this giant lion, like, wrestler boxer dude. I really dig that. Ranger Dex is a C, however Ranger Strength I give an S. It could be an S+ if there was any help with the spellcasting stuff. Beastmaster and all the subclasses, if they don't have something mechanically, like, for Beastmaster, and I want to explain some of my ratings on here. Beastmaster I rated a little bit higher if the race is small-sized, because that means that you can use the beast also as a mount. So there are some ways that you can build into that to make that pretty interesting. Just some basic feats or possibly multi-classing into Cavalier. You can do some pretty cool stuff with Beastmaster whenever you're small-sized. Rogue, no help with even intelligence, but no help with Dex. So across the board, they're getting a C. Scholar, C. You've heard of my other videos. Scholar is a intelligence support kind of backliner with a lot more roleplay-centric features. And this Leonin is all about a frontline-heavy character. Sorcerer, B, because you're getting the help to Constitution, but not much else is really helping out. And then Warlock and Wizard, both sitting at a C. Just no help with any kind of spellcasting stuff. And Yeah. This is also kind of the announcement that I am building onto this a little bit more. If a subclass has a feature that I feel could be heavily influenced by a racial feat, a racial feature, the thing that really made me decide that I should probably do that was whenever I considered something like Half-Orc Champion, right? So, like, with Champion, you're able to crit more often. Whenever you get Half-Orc, you're able to do more damage whenever you crit. So I feel like that is enough of a cool synergy to at least give it a little boost up and include them in my rating here. Same thing like I explained with like Cavalier or Beastmaster. You know, for Beastmaster, if you're small-sized, able to use it as a mount, there's some builds that you can go that can get a lot of perks out of that synergy. So that's it for the Leonin. You know, I think if I were to suggest like any change, really, I would probably give the Leonin maybe like 2 or 3 buffs. Number one, I would give them powerful build. I would give them some kind of a pounce attack. I think, you know, being able to move 20 feet towards a creature, and then if you make an attack against it with your claws, you can potentially knock it prone. That could be really cool. Just as they currently are right now, I'm like, ugh. And then the other change would be probably upping that to, you know, maybe changing it to a natural weapon attack, and then making it start out at a D6. That way, you know, you go into Monk, sure, whatever, you're doing the D6. I don't feel like that's that insane. You're getting 1 extra point average on damage. And then if you go Pugilist with it, the Pugilist already starts out with a D6. So, yeah. I just don't really know why they're nerfing the crap out of natural weapons right now. It seems like they're scared to give anything a damage dice above a D4, like, built into it. Especially with the Leonin, that should be something, like, terrifying, like, Wildcat-esque. I think if Leonin were something I was trying to feature a little bit more in the world of Luenta, I might, like, try and make some changes to it. But those are the only 2 things I would actually change, because I really feel like this race needs some help. But that's going to be it for this one, guys. That's the Leonin and the Mythic Odysseys of Theros. Let me know what you all think down in the comment section below. I'm just not really seeing the massive appeal to playing a Leonin over a Satyr right now. I guess other than you want to say your own roleplay expectations. So that's going to be it for this one. Do all the YouTube things, guys. Like, comment, subscribe. If you're new to my channel, I do a lot of D&D-related homebrew and homebrew design. I like to talk about different classes and subclasses, races, everything about the game. If that sounds like something that would interest you, why not go ahead and subscribe to my channel? I hope that you guys are staying safe out there, staying healthy, and I hope to see you in the next one.